And welcome back into the Ford Sports Sunday. Talking Gladiators football with the head coach of the Glads, Steve Tunn, is here. And the Glads, well, lost the first game of the year. Three-game winning streak, just coming off a tough loss the other night against Tampa. So a little bit of a roller coaster here to start the season.
Yeah, a little bit. We started off a little slow down in Georgia, and then we came back and we had three very good games. And then the other night we went to Tampa and we didn't play our best. It was a short week coming off the game last week at home. So it was a tough game. We didn't play real well. We turned the ball over way too many times. So it was just one of those games where when we got done, it was one of the ones where you just thought you gave it to them. And you just can't do that in our league. You just can't give games away. So hopefully we rebound pretty quick for this week.
And a lot of familiar faces back for the Glads this year, starting a quarterback with John Dutton, who up until this past weekend, right, even despite the six touchdowns, turned the ball over. But he's gotten off to a red-hot start for you guys.
He has. We struggled a little bit that first week, and he's had three great games. The offense has been clicking, and obviously defense has been playing well. But we struggled the other night, and it was kind of, you know, the guys were upset at the end of the game. It was really, you know, you hate to give the other team too much credit, but really they were our mistakes. So I think everything's correctable, and we'll get it straight for this game.
Again, some of the key teams as you guys get ready. I mean, Jacksonville's coming to the Q this weekend, 7:30 at the Q on Saturday night, so make sure you get out there and support your Gladiators. A couple of the key teams to watch this year, the strength. Are we looking at some of the same teams that back up at the top like last year?
They are. You know, you have Philadelphia, who we beat the other week. They're strong this year. Arizona's very strong, but they got upset last night. San Jose's strong. And then Jacksonville is the team that won it all last year. So, you know, they're about a 500 team this year, too. But they have a lot of good talent. They've made a few changes, and the biggest one is that quarterback. And they have a new quarterback this year. But they're going to be ready to go. They have a lot of talent. And you know, until somebody really knocks them off, they're still the champions from last year.
For you guys last year, defense down the stretch really kind of set the tone to help you finish the way that you guys finished. A lot of those familiar faces come back again this year. And so I imagine when you kind of put the team together and you look forward to this team, I mean, Dutton was there last year, Red was there last year, Goodman was there last year. Offensively, you're looking, wow, a lot of playmakers there. And then back on defense, I mean, Cheatwood's back again this year. You had a lot of the same guys. You must have felt pretty good at the start of the season that this is a team that certainly can make a long run in the Arena League.
We did. We were trying to get the core of guys back. In our league, everyone's a free agent, so sometimes it's tough to keep the whole team together. And we've changed our team. This is our third year, 3 years in a row. We have a lot of different players. But we tried to keep the core of the guys together, the Levy Brown, Tim Cheatwood, Joe Finnessy, guys who have been here. And the other thing is we wanted to stay physical on defense. And I think we brought in some great guys, some good guys on the defensive line. So we've done that defensively. We do have our receivers and John that have come back this year. But this is after five games, we've had five new offensive lines. We've had a lot of injuries, which is the way we ended up last year. So hopefully our offensive line can get more cohesive and keep guys healthy.
And I know people that are Gladiators fans and go to the games don't want to hear this, but you stress defense so much with this team because it's all about stops. Let's face it, on a field like that, it's about stops and getting the ball back in your own hands so you can score the points. But at the same time, where are you defensively? I mean, you lost a tough game to start. You lost a two-pointer to start the season. You go on a nice run. The defense played well in that stretch and then turnovers. But where are you at this standpoint with some of those guys that you just talked about?
You know, our defense is playing great. Overall, we're playing very well. We started off a little slow the other night against Tampa. We gave up a couple easy touchdowns, but then we came back and got two interceptions and did everything the defense had needed to do to get us back in the game, but then we had turnovers on offense. So defense is playing great. I think they're going to continue to play great. Offensively, we had three very good games there in between, but we just have to be more consistent just so we're not turning the ball over that much.
Is that one of the toughest challenges you get? Obviously, the players on your team understand whether you're playing defense or offense. Everybody wants to see a shootout. They want to see it to be 80-79 before it's all said and done, but to understand that the defense, as you so often have told right here on the show so many times, really the key for any good team in the Arena League, if you've got a good defense, you got a chance to be standing as the champ.
There's going to be shootouts. Arena football is made for shootouts. You're going to have 65 to 64 games. That's part of it. But there's also that time, even in a shootout, where you have to come up with a big stop or you have to make the big play or get the big interception. So now instead of having a 7-point lead, you have a 14-point lead in the fourth quarter. So, you know, I think we're getting there. We're all trying to work together and get this thing done. But overall, I'm pretty happy so far with both, but we have to stop just giving games away, at least make it competitive so we give ourselves a chance to win at the end of the game.
All right, the defending champ in town this week, Jacksonville, 7:30 at the Q. Coach, always good to see you.
All right, thanks.